Well, if you're feeling down and out and you're looking for a boost, how about this? Visualize two tiny parts of your brain and then exercise them, kind of like working out. Apparently, it makes you a happier person. That's Neil Slade's theory anyway. He's a teacher, a musician, and an author. The book's called The Frontal Lobe Supercharge. Neil Slade is with us now from Denver, Colorado. Okay, explain the brain tweaking for us.
Well, first of all, it's a proven hypothesis. It's
right.
Not a theory. We're talking about things in proven neurology. And what all I've done is I've extrapolated the practical points and made it easy to understand for anyone. We taught kids in kindergarten how to click their amygdala forward. So anyone, you know, age 6 to 106 can learn how to do this.
Okay, so how would you do it?
Well, the first thing you have to realize is you have to understand how the human brain works. It's kind of like knowing where to put the key in your car, what the gear shift lever does. So the first thing people do, they can go to the website, read one of the books, is learn brain basics, learn a model of the brain. And I brought a model of the brain here, and this is actual to scale size.
Okay.
And very quickly, I'll show you the main parts of the human brain. Now, of course, the brain is divided into two hemispheres, right?
Right.
And we'll put this part down. Okay, now, we use Dr. Paul McLean's model of the human brain when teaching people how the human brain works. And the human brain is three brains in one. The inner part here is what is called by researchers and medical people the R-complex, or reptile brain.
Right.
And it helps you to survive on the same level as a reptile. Now, surrounding that is another layer, kind of like the core around the seeds of an apple. And that's called the mammal brain, or the limbic system. Now, all of this part, which is usually what we think of when we think of the brain, is
right.
What you can see, that's called the primate brain. And the very whole front one-third, from this point forward, is your frontal lobes, and that's the most advanced part of the brain. And that's what we're trying to turn on with brain self-control, okay? Now, when you have fear and negative emotions, it's because all of the frontal lobes are turned off. You don't have any advanced frontal lobes processes happening. But when you turn them on, that's when you get all kinds of internal brain rewards, and that's when you feel happy and pleasure. And so the trick is a little tiny switch right here, and I'm pointing to it if you want to zoom in on that. It's called the amygdala, and it's one of your brain's master click switches.
Is that kind of and by the what eye?
Well, actually, if you put your thumbs in your ears, and your fingers in the corners of your eye and drag your finger down and point, 1 inch inside each temple is
right.
Your amygdala switch. So you've got one for the right hemisphere and one for the left. So it's about 1 inch inside each temple. Little master click switch called the amygdala. And the trick is to understand how all the brain works. And then there are lots of different games you can play and methods for clicking this amygdala forward. Now I brought this other little model that I made to show you what happens. Now we'll say this is the amygdala switch button inside your brain. It's really inside your brain, but here I've made it an external one because it's easy to get to. Now, deep inside the brain, we see the red fight or flight survival reptile brain turned on, right?
Right.
That's always on because it controls your breathing and your heart rate and temperature and allows you to run away from snakes and threats and things like that. If you click your amygdala switch forward, what it does is it then allows additional electrochemical activity to occur in the frontal lobes. And here we see now the amygdala has clicked the frontal lobes on full blast.
So for our viewers,
most of the time,
explain to us just a small little exercise we can do. So what you're saying is you kind of want to tickle the amygdala, right? You want to kind of
great.
Look like a feather. Not
that's,
really,
that's
but
one
you, know,
way
you imagine
to do
it.
Well, you imagine it. Your frontal lobes can compute abstract thought. You can imagine things. And when you do that, when you imagine things, create things in your mind that really don't exist, that automatically clicks on the most advanced parts of your brain. So very simple. If your viewers would just like to close their eyes while they're listening to me talk, imagine that you're holding a feather in one hand and that you can reach back through your forehead and tickle, 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 tickle. Your left amygdala button.
Kind of like
laugh.
Tickle me Elmo.
You know that laugh?
No, I'm laughing because, you know, it just sounds funny.
But that's
funny,
okay. But that's good. Laughter is computed in the frontal lobes. You just clicked your amygdala forward.
Well, there you
see?
Go.
Laughter and happiness is a positive emotion. And positive emotions are nature's way of encouraging us to do those kinds of activities that actually increase our survival. So when you click your amygdala forward and make yourself laugh, and when you think creatively, like tickling your amygdala, you're turning on the other 90% of your brain, as it were. Most of the time, we're only walking around. We've just got a tiny trickle going into the frontal lobes. But by learning how your brain works, by learning what the amygdala does, by learning the difference between your frontal lobes and your reptile brain, you can crank it up. And then, hey, you know, now we're talking about, you know, nirvana, that kind of thing.
The enlightenment, the meditation.
Every religion, even if you're an atheist, everyone has a word for this peak experience where you suddenly have an understanding of the big picture, as it were. And it's always indicated by these very wonderful positive emotions. It's a peak experience. And that happens only when the frontal lobes have been cranked up like this.
Okay.
Now, throughout history, there have been people who have accidentally, you know, clicked their amygdala fully forward, and those are our sages and some of our saints.
Neil, I'd love to keep talking. I gotta go though, but it's very interesting, and I know there's a lot of buzz about it. Thanks so much for joining us and explaining that to us.
Well, sure. Have fun clicking forward.
I will. Thanks so much, Neil.